official reclamador. They was Tony Antonius. Unfortunately, Geraldo couldn't come, but he was looking forward to seeing you and meeting you. He used to do that in his own country in Peru. And Tony is a great supporter of world poetry and a great supporter of the New Westminster community. And since we're having so many exciting technical problems, do you have that working?
Yes, it's working.
It doesn't matter that the lid's up?
I'm surprised it's working. Nothing has gone right for me today. I mean, nada.
Join the club.
Yeah. Well, I'll do a quick read, and then maybe I can do that.
Is the lid supposed to be up or down?
Down.
No, no, just...
I'll leave
yeah,
it.
Yeah, just leave it.
I might jinx it, you never know.
Well, it's women's... Women are being promoted this evening, and this woman is long gone, but she deserves all the love and support you can give her. Pauline Johnson. Very famous. And I'm going to read her poem that has always intrigued me, but it's so beautifully written. I am Ijosti. I am she, the wife of him whose name breathes bravery in life, and courage to the tribe that calls him chief. I am Ojisto, his white star, and he is land, lake, and sky, and soul to me. Ah, but they hated him, those Huron braves, him who flung their warriors into graves, him who had crushed them under his heel, whose arm was iron, and whose heart was steel to all, save me. Ojisto, chosen wife of my great Mohawk, white star of his life. Ah, but they hated him and counseled long with subtle witchcraft how to work him wrong, how to avenge their dead, and strike him where his pride was highest and his fame most fair. Their hearts grew weak as women at his name. They dared no war part since my Mohawk came. When ashen bow and flint and arrowhead to pierce their graven bodies, but they're dead. They must be avenged, avenged. They dared not walk in day and meet his deadly tomahawk. They dared not face his fearless scalping knife. So Niyo, God in the Mohawk language, so Niyo, then they thought of me, his wife. Oh, evil, evil face of them they sent with evil Huron speech. Would I consent to take on wealth? Be queen of all their tribe, have wampum ermine. Back I flung the bribe into their teeth and said, while I have life, know this, Ojisto is the Mohawk's wife. Why we struggled, but their arms were strong. They flung me on their pony's back with thong round ankle, wrist, and shoulder. Then uplift the one I hated most. His eyes, he wept over my misery and sneering said, thus, fair Ojisto, we avenge our death. And we two rode as the sea wind chased. I, bound with buckskin to his hated waist, he sneering, laughing, jeering, while he lashed the horse to foam, as on and on we dashed, plunging through creek and river, bush and trail, on and on we galloped like a northern gale. At last, his distant Huron fires aflame we saw, and nearer, nearer still we came. I, bound behind him in the captive's place, scarcely could see the outline of his face. I smiled and laid my cheek against his back. Loose thou my hands, I said, this pace let slack. Forget we now that thou and I are foes. I like thee well and wish to clasp thee close. I like the courage of thine eyes and brow. I like thee better than my bow hath. We cut the cords, we ceased our maddened haste. I wound my arms about his tawny waist. My hand crept up the buckskin of his belt, his knife hilt in my burning palm I felt. One hand caressed his cheek, the other drew the weapon softly. I love you, I love you, I whispered. Love you all as my life, and buried in his back his scalping knife. Ah, how I rode as a sea wind chased. Mad with sudden freedom, mad with haste, back to my Mohawk and my home, I lashed that horse to foam. As on I dashed, plunging through creek and river, bush and trail, on I galloped like a northern gale. And then my distant Mohawk's fires of flame I saw as nearer, nearer still I came. My hands all wet, stained with life's red dye, but pure my soul, pure as those stars on high. My Mohawk's pure white star, Ogisto, still am I.